My name's Simon Crafer. We're out on circuit in Catalunya to discuss circuit safety. And I know you want to get back to motorcycles and accessories, so we'll do that next race. But this is the last safety one for a while. I've had a good meeting with Franco Incini this morning, who's the FIM safety officer, and he's also the 1982 500 Grand Prix world champion, so a bit of a legend. I totally enjoyed the meeting. I actually had a poster of him on my bedroom wall amongst many other riders when I was young. So Franco explained to me that, let's give the example of a circuit that's never had a race before at it. So they want to have a Grand Prix. They contact Dorna. If there's a date available and it's interesting, whatever, they make the deal, it's a pre-contract, then they send the circuit, that says send a PDF of and a CAD file of the circuit. So without traveling anywhere, Franco can see how long the straights are, the layout, and where the barriers are, how close they are, and work out, first of all, what distances those fences need to be from the, you know what I mean, from the edge of the circuit. So, for example, Franco explained to me that if in a high-speed area like the end of this front straight, there's asphalt runoff, which the cars use a lot now on the tracks, and it's getting more and more. If they've got asphalt runoff too much and not enough gravel, because asphalt doesn't slow it down enough. He gave the example of, if it's a worst case scenario, dry line, so the bikes are going at dry racing speeds, but it's only just dried out because the bike's been riding there, it's wet on the asphalt runoff, then that asphalt does not slow the rider's body down, you know, enough before it gets to the gravel and then the fence. They did an experiment in the UK, Franco was telling me about that. They got a crash test dummy that weighed the same as a person, in leathers, fully dressed up helmet, turfed him out on an airfield at 200 kilometres an hour, varying speeds, but at 200 kilometres an hour with a wet surface, it took 187 metres to stop, which is way too much for too much asphalt runoff. You can see it doesn't slow you down. So the gravel bed, it does a much better job of slowing the rider and the bike down. And you have to have a certain amount of that before a fence. But the gravel also has to be prepared in a certain way, in that it used to be any old level, you know, back when I was riding. Then they discovered that if they keep it not higher, because the high makes the bike flip and roll, then if they have it the same level, still the friction change from surface of the asphalt to gravel grips and tends to flip, start rolling the bike and the rider. They figured out two centimetres lower, there's a bit of a transition period where it flies and then starts getting the friction building slower, less chance for chaos, you know, bikes flipping around. The FIA, who Franco Incini said has a really good relationship with the FIM, they've agreed and helped us on a few areas like this, where FIA used to, the tracks we both race at, Formula One and MotoGP, they used to have waves, and it was better at slowing down the cars apparently, but caused us chaos. And they've agreed now that all the circuits can be flat, which is good for us. Thank you, FIA. So if it's got enough asphalt and gravel runoff, still in certain zones, they do not, you know, high risk zones, they never left any fences uncovered. To give you an example, end of Mugello front straight, 119, something like that, meters from the edge of the track to the wall, and a bike's never made it out there. MotoGP's never made it out there, bike or rider. But Franco agrees with the FIA, who have six deep tire wall in front of the wall there. So no Armco, no bare concrete in any of those zones. So let's go to, if it's a high risk zone, a little bit close. They put, Franco can decide whether it's level A, grade protection, which can be foam or air fence. And Franco explained that there's actually an AA, which is a automatically pressure-controlled air fence, you know, so nobody has to keep an eye on the pressure, which drops over a day or hours. So it's obviously got a little electric pump in it. So he can grade whether it needs an A, a B, or a C level. A can be foam or air, like I said. But Franco said that head on, like square on, air absorbs the impact the best. But when it comes to glancing, like on an angle, problem with air is it can flip the riders up and the machine up and move the fence out of the way and then have to be red flagged. So depending on the angle of attack, what they put their air or foam, both A. Then if a less dangerous area, they can run a B bag, you know, which is probably less expensive for the track to hire, but is not required A anyway because it's low risk. And that again can be air or foam, but it's just the old model A's, you know, because they're always improving. So they have just the older model A in that area. And then C, the really low risk area, they'll run, it's a foam fence, you know, covering the wall, foam protection covering the wall. And then, so next, I think we should get on to the surface itself. So the asphalt obviously has to be a certain quality of grit to be MotoGP. And by the way, this homologation can be A, B, or C. A being MotoGP, B being World Superbike, and C being others. So let's get onto the asphalt. So the asphalt has to be a grade of 70 grip level or better. And I don't exactly know what the 70 stands for, but how they work it out is a pendulum. As scientists and engineers come up with a pendulum and with a rubber tip, and it touches, and the quicker it slows down, must be a time or something, the grippier the surface is. And the surface has to be 70 or better. And then, obviously, no big bumps and danger areas. Franco could say, hey, you have to, this will cause a crash. And so let's get on to the paint and the curb. The white line that runs around the edge the whole way around the track and the curbing has to be painted. And that paint, again, has to be homologated. Franco said it was a San Marino company that came up with the idea because the engineer in this company was a fan of Franco. And came up with, because Franco had been in Argentina at a GP, a lot of crashes because back when they didn't have homologated paint, someone had used some slippery paint, bunch of people down the road, and came back to Italy, met up with this engineer, and this engineer worked hard to come up with a grippy paint. It feels like sandpaper, you know, when you stand on it. So this paint, to be homologated, now a lot of countries come up with it. Germany, France, England, US, and San Marino all have homologated paints the circuits can buy and use. So 70 on the asphalt for this pendulum, it has to do really similar on the paint in the dry. And same when it's wet. Basically, the grip level on the paint has to be very similar to there, which is amazing because paint's normally slipperier. So then out onto the curbs. Let's talk about curbs. The curbs are 1 meter wide, the curb area. And on the outside, when you come out of corners, they have to be sloped down to give you less grip, you know, to make it less attractive to ride on them. And so that slope over 1 meter used to be 50 mil, now is 25. Franco said 50 was a little bit dodgy, caused a few riders whoop. So 25 seems good. FIA agreed, said fine. Now, just last race, Misano, the 1.5 meter, it's called Misano curbs now, because they're the first to try it. And it was Franco's idea to run 1.5 meters because it's easier for the rider to be accurate on. Obviously real narrow, difficult. So those are 1.5 meter wide with 25 mil drop over that one. Sorry, 1.5 meter wide with 50 mil drop sloping outwards. That's pretty much covered the lot. Hey, sorry about the mask of the people that don't like it. I have no choice. I've got to use it as long as these COVID problems happen. And next week or next race, we'll get back onto motorcycles and their accessories. I hope you've enjoyed homologation or track safety. Bye for now.